Welcome to a quick lesson on the graphing of the tangent function. The goals of this video are to graph the tangent function on the coordinate plane using the unit circle, and also to determine the domain and range of the tangent function. The name of the tangent function actually comes from the tangent line that is perpendicular to the radius and intersects the circle at a single point. To create a tangent segment, what we do is we draw a line perpendicular to the x-axis, as we see here, and then extend theta so that it intersects the tangent line. The tangent function is defined as the length of this red segment here, or the length of this tangent segment. Now you probably also remember that tangent theta is defined by y over x, where the point with coordinates xy would be where the terminal side of this angle intersects the unit circle. So you might be wondering, why is there a different definition for the tangent function now? And in fact, there isn't. There's actually two ways to define the value of tangent theta, using the tangent segment or using the ratio y over x. Let's take a look at why these are equal to each other. And in fact, this yellow triangle and this blue triangle are similar triangles. And notice that this blue triangle has this length leg 1 because this is a unit circle. So what we have are two similar triangles here where tangent theta is equal to y over x in the yellow triangle, but it's also equal to t over 1 in the blue triangle. And since these two triangles are similar, this forms a proportion, which means their cross products must be equal. So we'd have y times 1, which is y, must equal x times t. And of course, if we solve this equation for t, this shows that the length of this segment t is equal to the ratio of y over x. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the unit circle. Remember that if we have the unit circle, our tangent theta would be equal to the ratio of y over x. So to find function values, we'd have to take each of these ordered pairs and take the y-coordinate and divide by the x-coordinate. And that would be another way that we could find tangent function values. Let's go ahead and take a look at a Wolfram demonstration to get a feel for the graph of tangent theta. Now the graph of this function is a little more complicated than the graph of sine theta and cosine theta because we're graphing the function values as the ratio of y over x. So if we look at the angle 0 radians, this point would be 1, 0. Therefore y over x would be 0 over 1, or 0. Now as we approach pi over 2 radians, or 90 degrees, notice that the x-coordinate is approaching 0, while the y-coordinate is approaching 1. And in fact, the values get larger and larger. And then at pi over 2, it's actually undefined because we would have the point 0, 1, or 1 divided by 0, which we know is undefined. And that produces a vertical asymptote because tangent theta is undefined when x is equal to 0. And as we work our way around the unit circle, notice again, at 3 pi over 2, tangent theta is undefined, producing a vertical asymptote, and so on. Let's go and take a look at some negative angles now. Again, it's a little more involved than sine and cosine because it's a ratio of coordinates rather than just the x or y coordinate, and so on. Let's take a look at the entire graph. What we'll notice is there are vertical asymptotes when tangent theta is undefined, and that occurs where x is equal to 0, and that as we approach pi over 2 radians, tangent theta approaches infinity, and as theta approaches negative pi over 2, the function value approaches negative infinity. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at how we're going to graph this by hand. Let's go and graph this by hand now. I've already taken the time to complete this table for various angles and the value of tangent theta, but let me show you how I created this on the graphing calculator. First step, I typed in tangent x into y1. Next, I set my window so that it started at 0 and the independent variable was on ask. And lastly, I made sure that my calculator was in degree mode. And then I went to the table. And you can see I've already typed in several angles in degrees. And you won't see all of these in the table, but I could choose any angle I want now and find the function value. Notice at 90 degrees, the function is undefined because that's where the x-coordinate would be equal to 0. Let's go ahead and plot some of these function values. So 0 degrees, tangent theta is 0. At 30 degrees, it's approximately 0.58. At 60 degrees, it's 1.7. And then notice at 90 degrees, it's undefined. Again, that'll produce a vertical asymptote. So as this function approaches pi over 2, it increases without bound, like this. Now notice I wanted to see what was happening to the left of 0, so I chose negative 30 degrees, and that produced a function value of approximately negative 0.58. Divide this into thirds. Negative 60 is negative 1.7. And again, at negative 90, it's undefined, so we have a vertical asymptote. And so our function would look like this to the left of 0. This is one complete cycle of tangent theta, so our period is going to be pi radians. If I take a look at tangent theta at pi radians, or 180 degrees, it's 0. And to the left of this, it's going to resemble this piece here. And to the right of this, it's going to resemble this piece here. So we'll have another vertical asymptote at 3 pi over 2, and the function will look like this to the right. And now we could just copy and paste this into each interval of length pi. So what we'll notice on this function is that the range, the y values go up forever and down forever, therefore the range is all reals, but the domain will be all x's such that x does not equal some odd multiple of pi over 2. Notice we have 1 pi over 2, 3 pi over 2, next would be 5 pi over 2. And we can state that by saying 2n plus 1 times pi over 2. So as long as x doesn't equal an odd multiple of pi over 2, it's in the domain. Tangent theta does not have an amplitude because there's no max or min, and the period would be pi radians. Again, let's summarize what we have discovered. Tangent theta is graphed here in blue. Our domain, any x value that is not an odd multiple of pi over 2 radians, because that's where we have our vertical asymptotes. The graph is discontinuous and has vertical asymptotes. The x-intercepts occur at multiples of pi over 2. Here we see 0, pi, 2 pi for the x-intercepts. The period is pi. There is no amplitude. And the graph is symmetrical with respect to the origin, and therefore is an odd function. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.